Hello and welcome to After Before Friday, week four. This week I am working on a photo that was the very first photo I ever uploaded to my blog. It was before I had really gotten into post-processing. And as I look back at some of my earlier pictures, I see a lot wrong with them. This one specifically is oversaturated. And there are some items on the right-hand side of the screen that should have been cropped out. So I'm going to start and walk you through the process that I would do now were I uploading this picture today. So first, I'm going to crop the photo and get rid of the unwanted sections. So I come up to the crop overlay tool, and I click on that, and I'm going to slide in on the right, and slide in a equal proportion on the left, and I'm going to bring up the bottom, and then I'm going to click on the Done tool, on the Done button, and that will accept my crop. Now from there, I am going to deal with the oversaturation. To do that, I'm coming up to the Basics tab, click on that, and all the sliders available open up. And here, I'm going to deal with the clarity, or I'm sorry, with the vibrance slider first. Vibrance is a tool like saturation, but deals only with midtones. Saturation globally affects colors equally, where vibrance again only deals with the midtones. So I'm going to slide this pretty far down to the left to desaturate basically this creamy portion of the crab, and keeping the orange claws. Let's leave it there. The next thing I'm going to do is deal with the clarity. Clarity again is like contrast. It deals with the midtones. So contrast is a sledgehammer. It will darken edges globally on all tones. Clarity smart tool will darken the edges on the midtones. Either will give pop to the photo, but clarity is just a little bit more selective. So let's boost clarity just a bit. Okay. And then I'm looking at my histogram, and I see that I don't really have a white point, despite all the lighter tones. I don't really have a white point in the photo, and I like to have that. To deal with that, I'm going to come down to the white slider, and I'm going to boost it till right before the box on the right lights up. Once the box on the right lights up, that means that I've got some highlight clipping. If I crank it up, you'll see where the reds are. That's meaning those areas are now blown out. There will be no detail. So bring that back down to where clipping disappears. And there you go. I'm going to close the Basics tab, and I'm going to come down into the tone curve. I like to use Lightroom's preset medium contrast. Again, this deals with midtones as well. So I'll click on it, and you will see it's a slight difference, but enough of one to give it just a bit more of a punch. Close that, and I come down to the Detail tab. The Detail is where you do your sharpening and noise reduction. This, I don't need noise reduction on this one. However, sharpening is always nice to apply just a bit. I have a preset. I come over here, it's Sharpen JPEG, and I'll click on that, and you'll see in the screen what the change is. So just a hint of sharpening, which is nice. Again, adds a little bit more pop. I'm coming down to Effects. This is where I will add in my post-crop vignette, and I'm going to come over here. I have a heavier one. These are presets that come in Lightroom. This is a heavy vignette. As you can see, the amount is minus 35, which means it darkens the edges, and I think that's just a little bit too heavy. So here's a lighter one, and I like this effect as well. One last item that I want to address, and I actually should have done this before the vignette, but I want to darken this area on the top where this gentleman is standing. I don't want my eye to be pulled into the picture because of the light in this background. So the easiest way to do this in Lightroom is to use an adjustment brush, which is over here, and I will click on this and it will open the adjustment brush panel. To get into the area that I want to deal with, well, first of all, I need to reset all of these sliders to zero. So I'm going to double click on effect and it will zero all the sliders out. Because I want to decrease the exposure in this area, I'm going to load the adjustment brush with decreased exposure. And the number doesn't matter at this point. I just want a number that's large enough so that when I paint with the adjustment brush, I can see the effect, and then I can adjust the amount after the fact. So I'm coming over here and I left click to activate the area. You see a pin is dropped. The black in the middle of the pin means this pin is active. And now I'm going to paint and you'll see how it darkens the area. I think this is akin to layers in Photoshop, though I'm not a Photoshop user for layers. But I think it's along the same effect, layers and masking. Now there's a handy little button here in Lightroom. If you come down here and you click on Show Selected Mask Overlay, you'll see it highlights in red the area that I painted on. So I can go in and I can see the areas I've missed. I can also zoom in using 1:1 so that it's easier to paint. And if I happen to go outside of an area like this, on my PC, I hit Alt, and it changes it into a minus button, and I just brush over and it removes. The same on this side. Let me come back out to the full view. I want to paint this area as well. And then I'm going to come back here and I'm going to remove that overlay and I will play with the exposure to see where I want it to be. I actually think that's probably good. And then I'm also going to add, this is a little fun fact, the sharpness slider, if I move it all the way to the left, kind of acts, it blurs. It acts, it gives a little bit of a shallower depth of field feel. To this area, which I like. So I think that's about it. I'm going to click done and I'm going to accept it. So here is the after, and I'll go back in the history and I will see the before. Here's the before. Yikes. And here's the after, which I think is a whole lot better, though, you know, crab are kind of scary looking creatures, but much better photo. And I have to admit that I have now uploaded this photo to my original post. I could not bear keeping that original upload there. So I hope that perhaps you've picked up a tip or two, and if you would like to participate in AB Friday, I'd love to have you on board. Check out the AB Friday forum page on my blog, and for all the guidelines. Thanks so very much for viewing.